Now, this exercise is important, again, not so much because you will use it really to sketch a graph, sketch a function. However, it's a commonly asked question to state whether the function is even or odd. So there are two types of symmetry we talk about. They are even functions and odd functions. So an even function is symmetrical, usually along a vertical axis of symmetry, and an odd function has point symmetry. Now, point symmetry is if we were to take a central point, and it's usually the origin, and spin the graph 180 degrees around that one point, not reflect it, but spin it. If you get back to the original graph just by doing that, then we say that the function is odd. Now, that's the description of odd and even or symmetry in terms of the graph. And we also have definitions for odd and even graphs algebraically. So algebraically, the rule that we learn is this one, for an even function. It says it's possible to determine algebraically whether a function is even by testing the following. So if f of x, the expression you have for f of x, if it is exactly equal to the expression when you substitute negative x in and simplify and tidy and whatever, then you can, if they are exactly equal, then you can say, from using the algebraic test, that the function would be even. The idea of establishing that the function is even, I suppose, when you come to draw a graph, is that if you know that the graph does that on the positive side, and it's usually easy to substitute a couple of positive values for x in to get the idea of what the graph's doing. And then if we've established that this function, whatever it was, if we could establish it graph algebraically by following this little process, then we wouldn't need to plot the remainder of the x values. We would know it would, so this point goes to this point goes to this point, and then we come back down and then we go up. So we get that sort of thing. So that would be our entire function. And now I don't know about you, but sometimes even just to have sub minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, whatever, may not take any longer than to actually show this. So it will depend on the how complicated the function actually is. But like I said, sometimes this actual process is more involved than subbing a few values into an equation and plotting the points. So like I was saying, it's not so... This concept is not so often used to sketch a graph. However, it's here in this whole sketching functions topic. But rather, you are just straight out asked to show whether a function is even. So in that case, that's really a question testing that you know this algebraic property. The algebraic property for an odd function now, and here it's just demonstrating that an odd function has point symmetry. So if you imagine, and that's what I've got the arrow, you imagine taking this point and spinning it and spinning it down. So once we've gone from here to here, we've only gone through 90 degrees. We have to spin it a total 180 degrees. If after spinning it only 180 degrees, because obviously if you spin it 360 degrees, you'll get back to where you were. But if after spinning it only 180 degrees, an exact half revolution, if it traces out the original function that it was, then you can say that the function is odd. Now, that's graphically the representation, and I suppose that yes, if you have plotted your positive section, you know then that imagine spinning that right around and creating the other side, and algebraically we've got a property that says you can show that a function is odd if into the function you substitute negative x, simplify, do whatever. If that then is equal to the negative of the function, so you put negative outside whatever the whole function is, distribute the negative throughout the function. Now, if those two expressions end up being exactly equal, algebraically, then you can say you have an odd function. And again, to be honest, this concept of establishing whether it's odd using this and then going back and using that to actually construct the rest of your graph is, I would say, not very often used. However, it is very common to get a question, especially in mathematics, asking you to show whether a function is odd. So yes, you have to, yes, you do have to know this property. So it's this algebraic statement that has to hold true for an odd function, and this algebraic statement that holds true for an even function. And most questions testing this are algebraic questions.